It is May 1962. An experiment is being conducted in the Elegant Interaction Laboratory at Yale University. The subjects are 40 males between the ages of 20 and 50 residing in the greater New Haven area. They were obtained by a newspaper advertisement and direct mail solicitation. The subjects range in occupation from corporation presidents to good humor men and plumbers, and an educational level from one who had not finished elementary school to subjects who have doctorate and other professional degrees.
Now, both of you have been paid, so let me sit right down here. So let me say that the checks are yours simply for showing up at the lab. And from this point on, no matter what happens, the money is yours. I should like to tell both of you a little about the memory project. Psychologists have developed several theories to explain how people learn various types of material. Some of the better-known theories are treated in the book over there, The Teaching-Learning Process by Cantor. One theory is that people learn things correctly whenever they get punished for making a mistake. A common application of this theory would be when parents spank a child if he does something wrong. But actually, we know very little about the effect of punishment on learning because almost no truly scientific studies have been made of it in human beings. For instance, we don't know how much punishment is best for learning. And we don't know how much difference it makes as to who's giving the punishment, whether an adult learns best from an older or younger person than himself, or many things of this sort. So what we're doing in this project is bringing together a number of adults of different occupations and ages, and we're asking some of them to be teachers and some to be learners. We want to find out just what effect different people have on each other as teachers and learners, and also what effect punishment will have on learning in this situation. Therefore, I'm going to ask one of you to be the teacher here this afternoon, and the other to be the learner.
This machine generates electric shocks, and when you press one of the switches all the way down, the learner gets a shock. When you release it, the shock stops, you see, like that. The switch will remain in this middle position after you've released it to show you which switches you've used on the board. Of course, if you were to press any one of them again, the learner would get another shock.
All subjects are given identical instructions and a sample shock.
I'm going to ask you to close your eyes and estimate the number of volts you receive in the sample shock. Do not open your eyes until I tell you to do so, please. Would you close them now? Okay, you may open your eyes, and using the voltage scale here, would you estimate for me the number of volts you received, please? You may also use the verbal designations, slight, moderate, strong, so forth, to help you. Sam,
a number, please?
Would you?
About 75. 75?
No, actually, it was 45 here. Although it may have seemed stronger because of the electrode paste, which provides a perfect contact. All right, let's go on to our instructions. We will begin with this test. You will read each pair of words in this list once to the learner until you've read through the entire list. Direct your voice toward that microphone as the rooms are partially soundproof. After you've read through the list once, you will go on to the next page. And here, starting from line A, you'll read the word in large letters, along with each of the other words in the line. For example, in the first line, you'd read blue, boy, girl, grass, hat. Now, after you've read the four choices, the learner pushes one of the switches on the board in front of him, and the number he has selected will light up in this box, 1, 2, 3, or 4. Now, if he gives the correct answer, you say correct and go on to the next line. The correct answer is underlined and is also indicated in the right margin.
Yeah.
If he were to indicate the wrong answer, you would say wrong. Then tell him the number of volts you're going to give him. Then give him the punishment. Then read the correct word pair once. And then go on to the next line. For example, if he indicated 3 for blue, you would say wrong. 15 volts. You press and release the switch. Read blue girl. And then go on to the next line.
I see.
Now, each time he gives a wrong answer, you move up one switch on the shock generator. And it's important that you follow this procedure exactly. So to help you, let me go through it again very quickly.
Right.
I would suggest you read the list and the test at a brisk pace to keep it moving.
The victim was an accomplice of the experimenter. The drawing was rigged so that the naive subject was always the teacher, and the accomplice always became the learner.
Well, of 100 people placed in this situation, how many do you think would just go right on to the end? And Mr. Wallace were out there, and say Mr. Williams, for some reason or other, said, keep going.
You're asking me how many
out of 100, right?
Well, personally, I think if you get one or two, you'd be lucky.
Well, I'm not sure lucky is the right word.
40 psychiatrists at a leading medical school were also asked to predict the performance of 100 hypothetical subjects. They predicted that only a little more than 0.1% of the subjects would administer the highest shock on the board. Yet actually, 50% of the subjects obeyed the experimenter's commands fully in the experiment depicted in this film.
165 volts. Time.
Continue, please. Go on.
There's a lot of them here. You know, they have a heart condition to... You want me to go?
Just continue, please.
Sharp. Axe, needle, stick, blade. Ask, please. Wrong. I'm up to 180 volts.
Please continue, teacher.
Needle, you're going to get a shock. 180 volts.
Ow! I can't stand the pain. Let me out of
here. Can't stand it. I'm not going to kill that man. Eh? You hear him hollering? He's dying.
I said before, the shocks may be painful, but they're not dangerous.
They're hollering. He can't stand it. What if something happens to him?
The experiment requires that you continue, teacher.
Yeah, but I'm not going to get that man sick of that. I mean, he's hollering in there. You know what I mean?
Whether the learner likes it or not, we must go on until he's learned all the word pairs.
I'd refuse to take the responsibility of him getting hurt in there. I mean, he's under hollering.
It's absolutely essential that you continue, teacher.
There's too many left here, and I mean, geez, he gets wrong here. There's too many of them left. I mean, who's going to take the responsibility if anything happens to that gentleman?
I'm responsible for anything that happens here. Continue, please.
All right, next one. Slow. Wrong. Answer his neck. 300 volts.
Oh! I absolutely refuse to answer anymore. Get me out of here. You can't harm me here. Get me out. Get me out of here.
Continue. The next word is green, please.
Green. Grass, hat, ink, apple.
If the learner doesn't answer in a reasonable time, about 4 or 5 seconds, consider the answer wrong and follow the same procedure as you have been doing for wrong answers. Say wrong, tell them the number of volts, give them the punishment, read them the correct answer.
Oh, man.
Continue, please.
Something's happened to that man in there. Nice one. Gold, dollar, necklace, moon, paint. Something's happened to that man in there. You better check in on him, sir. He won't answer me or nothing.
Please continue. Go on, please.
You accept all responsibility?
The responsibility is mine. Correct. Please go on.
Grave. Woman. Soldier. Dog. Horse. Answer is woman. 450 volts. That's it.
Now continue using the last switch on the board, please. The 450 switch for each wrong answer. Continue, please.
I'm not getting no answer.
Please continue. The next word is white.
You think you should look in on him, please?
Not once we've started the experiment.
But what if something's happened to him and had an attack or something there?
The experiment requires that we continue. Go on, please.
Don't the man's health mean anything?
Whether the learner likes it or not,
but he might be dead in there. I mean, some people can't take this shock, sir.
Please continue.
I don't tend to be rude, but I mean, I think you should look in on him. All you got to do is look at the door. I don't get no answer, no noise. Something I think has happened to the gentleman in there, sir.
We must continue. Go on, please.
You're going to keep giving him what, 450 volts every shot now?
That's correct. Continue. The next word is white.
White. 450 volts. Next one is short. Sentence, movie, skirt, time.
All right, excuse me, teacher. We'll have to discontinue the experiment. I'd like to ask you a few questions, if I may.
How do you feel, though?
I feel all right, but I don't like what's happened that I fall in there. He's been hollering, and we had to keep giving him shocks. I didn't like that one bit. I mean, he wanted to get out, and he just kept going, kept throwing 450 volts. I didn't like that. He wouldn't even look at him, that gentleman.
Well, Well, who was actually pushing this wish?
I was. But he kept insisting. I told him no, but he said he got to keep going. I told him it's time we stopped when we got up to 195, 210 volts.
But why didn't you just stop?
He wouldn't let me. I wanted to stop.
Many people, not knowing much about the experiment, claim that subjects who go to the end of the board are sadistic. Nothing could be more foolish as an overall characterization of these persons. The context of their action must always be considered. The individual, upon entering the laboratory, becomes integrated into a situation that carries its own momentum. The results, as I observe them in the laboratory, are disturbing. They raise the possibility that human nature cannot be counted on to insulate men from brutality and inhumane treatment at the direction of malevolent authority. A substantial proportion of people do what they are told to do, irrespective of the content of the act and without limitations of conscience, so long as they perceive that the command comes from a legitimate authority. If in this study, an anonymous experimenter could successfully command adults to subdue a 50-year-old man and force on him painful electric shocks against his protests, one can only wonder what government, with its vastly greater authority and prestige, can command of its subjects.